Do you know that green is my favorite color? And chartreuse, a shade of green, is my daughter's favorite color. People's taste in colors varies widely, making it impossible to pin down the world's most popular hue. What to do if I need to reveal this information? I polled a big number of individuals and found that 35 of them preferred the color blue as their first pick. Green grabs the second spot with 22%, followed by purple, red, and orange. You may be wondering as to how color relates to statistics. Well, doing statistics is no different from conducting a survey and determining the most popular color among respondents. To put it another way, statistics is the study of data and finding important conclusions from it. Small data sets like height of all family members is easy to analyze. However, we need special tools to make relevant inferences for large data sets like income of all citizens of a country. That's where mean, median, and mode can really help us out. In order to comprehend the broad picture and understand what the data signifies about the world we live in, we need to know these three fundamental features of data sets. Maybe the mean is a new concept to you, but you've probably heard the term the average before. If this is the case, I have some exciting news to share with you. When you say mean, you're referring to the average. The phrases mean and average refer to the same thing in statistical language. To understand what it is, let's look at a simple data set that contains 7 numbers. The block counts in each stack indicate the numbers in the set. But what if we rearrange the blocks with the goal of making all the stacks of same height? Alternatively, how much would each stack contain if it had the same number of items? It turns out that with a little trial and error, we have enough blocks for each stack to have a total of 5 blocks. This means that the mean, or average, for our original data set would be 5. If the quantities are equalized, all of the numbers would be 5 regardless of how high or low they are. You can smooth out or flatten all of your data to produce a single consistent result, and that is what mean is. However, is there a technique to calculate the average of a set of data using math? Let's go back to the basics and learn how to calculate the mean mathematically. Now, let's adopt a more systematic approach of making all the stacks of same height. This method combines addition with division in a crafty way. To begin, add all numbers of the data set together, as though stacking them all in a big pile. When you add up all the numbers, you get 35. After that, divide the stack into 7 equal portions. Since there are 35 blocks in the stack, dividing it into 7 equal stacks gives us 5 in each, because 35 divided by 7 equals 5. Now it's time to move on and learn the concepts of median. The median is the middle number in a sorted, increasing or decreasing list of numbers, and can be more descriptive of that data set than the average. Let's arrange the numbers in increasing order. The smallest and largest numbers are 2 and 9, respectively. We must now determine the middle number in order to find the median. To get the intermediate number, take a step up and a step down from the lowest and highest stacks, respectively. Jump likewise from the second smallest and second tallest stack. Continuing such jumps will finally take you to the middle stack or middle number, which is 5. So, in this example, the median equals 5. Now let's add one more data point to this data set. Let the value of that data set be 6. This will give you 2 middle numbers, as the total number of data points are now even, unlike the previous data set where the total number of data points were odd. Whenever you encounter a situation like this, just take the average of the 2 numbers, add the 2 numbers, and divide them by 2. This will give you the midpoint between 5 and 6 as the median value. Median is different from the mean, but both values pretty much give us the central value of this set of numbers. But why do we need the median? Isn't mean enough? To better appreciate the need for the median, let's look at an example. Let's say you want to play a TV station for a group of people ranging in age from 6 to 83, who are all in your house. You decide to find a mean value of the ages listed here. Mean, or average, is the sum of values divided by the number of values. Adding all these numbers equals 115. So the mean age would be 115 divided by 5. It's a fascinating outcome you've obtained. You'll discover that the average person is 23 years old. As a result, you decide to screen a film targeted at an audience aged around 23. Consider the situation once more. There are 4 kids and a senior person in this group, but the average age is about the same age of a college graduate. Does it make sense? Is the median a good representation of the entire group? Will that movie be liked by children? No, I doubt it. And what about Grandpa? Will he get his fair share of fun? Maybe no is the answer once more. In this case, the mean is not a good representation of the central value, and that is because the data is skewed by this age, which is unusually large, as compared with the rest of the values. The median age is used to give a more accurate portrayal of the group's demographics. To do this, we'll have to rank the years in ascending order. This is what we come up with: 6, 7, 7, 12, and 83. The median age will be the middle of the 5 values. It will be 7 years, as it falls exactly in the middle. So the median definitely gives us a far better representation of the age of the people. Cartoon Network is better suited for the majority of its audience, and chances are excellent that even Grandpa appreciates cartoons at this point in time. The median made more sense here than the mean. Let's again revisit the data set. 83 is a huge number with respect to 6, 7, 7, and 12. Such unusually big numbers, or unusually small numbers in the data set, tend to shift the average towards them. Such numbers are called outliers, and the presence of outliers makes the mean unfit for it to be the true representation of age of family members watching TV. Now, what about the mode? How can we calculate the mode? Simplest terms for mode are most common or highest frequency. Except for 7, all the numbers appear just once. The number 7 appears twice in this mode, making the mode's value equal to 7. This is a piece of cake. The number that appears the maximum times becomes the mode. But here's a more important question. Where do we use mode? Mode is used in categorical data, where we wish to know which is the most common category. Let's understand it with an example. Suppose we survey a group of people and ask about their favorite mode of transportation. We provide them with 4 categories to choose from: car, train, bus, and tram. We found that 20% preferred car, 10% liked train as their favorite mode of transportation, 15 chose tram over other forms, and a whopping 55% liked bus the most. Hence, bus becomes the mode, as this form of category is the favorite way of transportation of maximum number of people. Thus, mode is used where data is categorized in subgroups, and it tells which group has maximum number of an entity falling in it. With this, we come to the end of this video, and I hope you've enjoyed it. By the way, don't forget to tell us your favorite color by typing it in the comment box below. Thanks, and have a good day.